I think what Andy's undertaking to row around Britain in aid of the RNLI is absolutely superb. I wouldn't want to do that trip with an engine, let alone rowing myself with wooden oars, so hats off to him for that. The majority of the guys who go to sea here and everywhere else around the coast are all volunteers. They're giving up their time to go and help others. They'll turn up in the middle of the night, in the middle of the winter, with the wind blowing and the waves crashing. They'll turn up here ready to go, putting themselves on the line for other people. Here at Senen, you know, we do suffer some really severe conditions. We lie just about a mile north of Land's End, on the very tip of the mainland. We get tides that congregate around Land's End Point itself, so you get a lot of very unpredictable currents. You know, when those winds whip up, they can be coming in force 10, 11, 12. You can have really heavy groundswell coming all the way across the Atlantic, and it hits here first. The area is scattered with dangerous rocks, but if you looked at the water, you wouldn't know they were there. Historically, we've had hundreds of shipwrecks on this part of the coast. You know, when it's bad, it can be really bad. Through luck or judgment, Andy's picked a really good day today to round Land's End. We've got close to perfect conditions, just a little bit of a breeze, almost no swell, and he's planned his timings just right with the tide. So as he rounds Land's End Point, the tide will just about be turning and aid him up towards St Ives. So he's picked a good time to do it, but the area is treacherous for big shipping. So to be in a small boat rowing around the coast unaided is absolutely superb and a massive thing to undertake. He's definitely got our respect and our thanks for doing that.